Hey everyone, back with you with Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. Oh, it's JC6 here. Okay, so we're back in the trial of. I'm recording this like nine. This part of the section, I'm recording it 9 months after the last section because. Well, I haven't found a good time to upload the past videos until recently. So, here we go. Don't worry, I'm not here to hinder your trial. Just remember, if this turns out to be a big waste of time, don't say I didn't warn you. Very well, the witness may now begin his testimony. And so, not an incident. As I recall, Neil and I were questioning him that day. To make a long story short, we slipped up. The power outage didn't help either. When I went to my office, I found Lana there. Apparently, she had already arranged the crime scene. As you can see, I had nothing to do with the forgery. Is that when Dark was arrested? Him? He was lying on the floor unconscious. When Emma sent Neil flying, it seems Dark bumped his head. I see everything seems pretty clear-cut. If the police chief has the right to refuse to testify, they better hit him hard and fast. As I recall, Neil and I were questioning him that day. When I went to my office, I saw Lana there. Could you tell us what you saw? It was a shocking sight. You and that serial killer were lying in a heap on the floor, tangled together. Well, next time were those two poor girls. Man, this doesn't look good for my client. She already arranged the crime scene. Let's see, arranged the crime scene. How can you know that? Because of the victim's body, it already been moved. So that means, found the body near Lana's desk? I think you said earlier it was my suit of armor that really stabbed the prosecutor. Anyway. Oh yeah guys, I'm going to give you guys a heads up. This is probably going to be my last Let's Play before. This is probably going to be the last Let's Play I'm going to do before I, because right now I'm actually thinking about joining the military. So, I'm probably going to just stop it with Phoenix Wright, stop it for, I guess, 4 years, because I'm planning on actually joining the Navy. Hiding evidence are inexcusable no matter what the circumstances. If you're gonna stare at anything, you better be off staring at the court record. Always a smooth talker. Which piece of evidence ties Dan to the forgery? Lana did admit to forging evidence. That can't be the whole truth. Somehow got a link down to the incident. Let's see, who told the police department that day. If that's right, I guess you could say I'm a workaholic. After winning his award, Neil was all fired up too. The car was too dark and made him run away like that. Was the defendant Lionel Skye also present in the room? I don't quite remember. At the very least, he wasn't there when the dark ran for it. Let's see. I'm trying to look for the piece of evidence. It's the evidence list. It had nothing to do with the forgery. Wait a second. Didn't we find evidence in Dan's office? So, let's see. If you really had nothing to do with the forgery, how do you explain this? What's that? And what's on it? A handprint? Chief Dan, your explanation, please. I don't know, you tell me, son. Huh? My dear Raito, don't you know? The second rule of evidence law? Uh-oh, not this again. Rule 2, unregistered evidence presented must be relevant to the case in trial. Tell me, how is that rag relevant to this trial? Vince is terribly sorry. What? Well, at least I didn't get penalized for it, so that's good. That power outage didn't help either. Let's see, but that can't be the whole truth. That's the link back to the incident. To make a long story short, we slipped up. I found Lana there. Let's see. I mean, okay, let's try the jar. You claim it had nothing to do with the forgery. Hopefully that is a claim we can have back up. Several pieces of evidence are found in your office. Take this jar, for example. Yeah, but the evidence list I presented earlier is actually found inside your desk. You see, Chief Dan, these articles of evidence uncovered in your office are both concrete proof that you also played a part in the legal investigation. Chief Dan, what's the meaning of this? Oh, here's a defense attorney who may even rival Worthy. So you admit to it then, that you were involved in the forgery? Or do you mean you? What? Me? Why would I have anything to do with that? You were the one who snuck into my office when you found this evidence. prosecutors aren't the only ones capable of forging evidence, you know? How will Detective Gunfield trust during the investigation? Not even detectives are exempt from the law. Rest assured, Dick will receive his due punishment. If Detective Gumshoe's salary drops any further, he'll end up paying to work. Yes, well, in light of the detective's presence, please give us your testimony regarding these pieces of evidence found in your office. Guess these days no longer know how to put two and two together. But where do you put two and two? I mean, is you're guilty. I mean, where do you put two and two with that in your office so you're guilty? I could have planted them in my office when those pieces of evidence were discovered. Now after Dark was convicted, then they're worthless. There's no reason I'd participate in forgery. Rearranging the crime scene wouldn't help me out in any way. Investigating the crime scene, you should have been more careful to observe protocol. You do understand I am the chief of police, right? There will be consequences. I believe I will press charges so you won't make the same mistake again. Alright, Uggy, in return though. Were these guys telepathic? I can't prove when they were discovered. Let's see, Emma's down. Let's see. Can we flip? I was wondering if we could flip the flip picture over. There's Emma Sky's prints. There's no reason I participate in forgery. Wait, participate in the forgery? Right now I'm trying to think. I guess we should just press everything, I guess. I mean, I don't know. At the very least, there is one very large benefit you reap from this. That would, of course, be the position you have, Chief of Police. The resolution of the SO9 incident secured your promotion to Chief. That in itself is sufficient motive. Oh, that's a good one. Well, you really think I'm that incompetent? What do you mean? Even without that case, I was already in line to become the next chief. The resolution of SO9 merely sped up the inevitable a little. Yes, he was going to be made chief anyway. Be careful and point that thing, or you might wind up being the one pointed at. Only one possible motivation for you to commit forgery. Then you did for someone else. You know me better than that. There are only three people I look out for. Me, myself, and I. That's just one person. There, it's out in the open now. Would you mind if I change my testimony a little? Nothing in it for you? Let's see, Well, okay, guys, I'm gonna stop it right here. Next time, we'll see what Chip Gaines. We'll see what. We'll try to connect Chip Gaines to the case. Take care, everybody. I'll see you guys next time.